إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وبعد. Dear brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today we're going to be talking about a major, major sin. Something that even many people do not even imagine is a sin. And there are even some people who think that performing this deed is optional. They think that if they do this deed, you're somehow a better Muslim than someone who does not. In fact, I know in some places they even have a special word for the person who does this deed. They call this person a namazi, a person who actually prays five times a day. But in reality, my brothers and sisters, the person who abandons the salah, who abandons the five obligatory prayers, according to what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, and according to what many scholars have understood, that person is not a Muslim. That person is actually a disbeliever and an apostate from the religion of Islam. So let us look at this major, major sin, this serious crime, this terrible transgression of abandoning the obligatory prayers. Let's begin by looking what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Al-Maryam, which is the 19th surah, in verses 59 to 60. Then there succeeded a generation which neglected prayers and followed lusts. They will meet with destruction, excepting the one who repents and believes and acts righteously. So let's just think about what is being said here. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about generations who came after the time of the prophets. So Allah sent messengers, and each messenger had with him a group of people who did what he asked them to do. But those prophets were followed by generations. Generations whose sayings were contrary to their actions and who did things they were not asked to do. They innovated, they brought new things into the religion. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever struggles against such people with their hand is a believer, and whoever struggles against such people with their tongue is a believer, and whoever struggles against such people with their heart is a believer, but after that there is not a mustard seed's worth of faith. So there we have it. The prophets, with them were generations of people. They did the things they were asked to do. And one of the things all the messengers were given is the command to establish regular prayer. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, there is no good in a deen, there is no good in a way of life without regular prayer. So all of the prophets had regular prayer as part of what they were ordered to do and what they ordered their followers to do. But what happened? After those prophets died, after those generations who were with the prophets passed away, what happened? Another generation came. And those generations, what happened to them? They neglected prayers and followed lusts. So they started to go after following their desires. And that is linked with their neglecting prayers. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he told us and he warned us that a person whose prayer does not keep them from disobeying Allah, that prayer actually only increases the distance between them and Allah. And that is because the purpose of prayer, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he stated in the Quran, and he told us and reminded us that part of the reason, the wisdom, the purpose of Allah ordering us with prayer is that the prayer helps to keep us away from wickedness, fahisha, which is the open lusts, following of lusts and desires, and munkar, which means evil. So these people, they neglected their prayers and they followed their desires, and the two things are going to come together. When you neglect your prayers, then you will start even more, and all of us, we are going to follow our desires. But when you are not praying, then it is even more that you will follow your desires. So what did Allah say? They will meet with ghay, destruction. They will meet with destruction. Excepting, of course, the person who repents and acts righteously, because, my brothers and sisters, the doors of repentance are always open. Now, I want to read here what Abdullah ibn Abbas said about these verses of the Quran. And if you think about this, brothers and sisters, you're going to find it really shocking. You're going to be shocked. Because actually, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about the people who neglected their prayers, it doesn't mean, according to Abdullah ibn Abbas, that they stopped praying altogether. No. What it means is they didn't pray their prayers on time. They left their prayers to the end of the time. So what did they do? The Fajr prayer, they left it until just before sunrise. The midday prayer, they left it until just before the afternoon prayer. The afternoon prayer, they delayed it until just before sunset prayer. The sunset prayer, they delayed it until just before the night prayer. And the night prayer, they left it maybe until before the dawn or just then. They delayed the prayers. This is what Abdullah ibn Abbas said. And he said, if anyone dies without repentance in this matter, Allah has promised ghay for him or her. And that is a valley in hell, which is very deep and has foul food. Oh, my brothers and sisters, please think about this. If that is the punishment for people who neglect the prayer, meaning they leave it to the end of the time and they're not careful about praying it in good time, what do you think is going to happen to a person who doesn't pray at all or who even abandons some of their prayers? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, فَوَيْلٌ لِلْمُسَّلِينَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ صَلَاتِهِمْ سَاهُونَ in Surah Al-Ma'un. So woe be to those worshippers who are unmindful of their prayer. And Allah still called them worshippers. He still called them worshippers. But he said, وَيْلٌ لِلْمُسَّلِينَ woe be to those. Wail is again a valley in hellfire. Wail is a valley in hellfire that is very, very hot. So Allah is warning of a valley in hellfire for the worshippers, meaning they worship Allah. They're upon Tawheed, they're not making shirk. These are people who are not making shirk. They're worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they are praying, but they are neglecting and they are uncareful and they are unmindful of the prayer. And according to Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas, he said, I asked Allah's Messenger about this. He asked Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas, he asked the Prophet about, what does this mean? What is this meaning, unmindful of the prayer? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, is delaying the prayer up to the end of its prescribed time. That is about a person who prays, but they leave their prayer to the end of the time, and they're still praying it in time. They haven't even missed a prayer. They pray it on time, within the time. Inna salata kanat ala al-mu'minina kitaban mawquta. Verily, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, certainly the prayer has been prescribed upon the believers at fixed times, and the times are what we know them to be. But if the person keeps delaying and keeps delaying and keeps delaying and does this consistently and does this regularly, and that becomes their habit, then they have been described like this, as the unmindful ones. And Allah has threatened them with a punishment in a specific place in the hellfire. How about the one who then doesn't pray at all? If that's the punishment, and that's the warning of a person who prays on time, how about the person who leaves it outside the time, or who doesn't pray at all? My brothers and sisters, if you think about this, it will make you very, very scared and it will make you very, very frightened. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He warns us, O you who believe, in Surah Al-Munafiqun, which is the 63rd surah, in ayah number 9, He warns us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warns us, O you who believe, let neither your wealth nor your children detract you from the remembrance of Allah. And those who do so, they will be the losers. When Allah says you're going to be a loser, you will be a loser. You will be a loser in this dunya, in this world, and you will be a loser in the akhirah, in the life to come. And the people, the mufassirun, the people who commented on the Quran, they said that here the remembrance of Allah, the dhikr of Allah, means the prayers. Brothers, so busy working, so busy at your desk, so busy in the office, so busy in the shop, so busy doing your work, you don't have time to pray. You leave your prayer outside its time. And this clearly shows and belies those people who claim that you can join all your prayers up at the end of the day, your dhuhr and asr and maghrib and isha, and pray them all in one go. No. That is leaving the prayer outside its prescribed time. The time is prescribed. If you do not pray your dhuhr, by the time the dhuhr has finished, you missed it. And you can never ever catch it up again. Because dhuhr, for example, on this day, dhuhr on this day that you are watching this program, was dhuhr on this day, on that time, from whatever time it was, 12 o'clock until 4:30 when it finished, or whatever the time may be. If you didn't pray it in that time, you missed it. إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ كَانَتْ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ كِتَابٌ مَوْقُوتًا. Verily the prayer has been enjoined upon the believers at fixed times. If you missed the fixed time, you missed it, you lost it. You can never make it up again. Of course, what you can do is pray nawafil and pray extra prayers by way of tawbah, by way of repentance. And brothers and sisters, the doors of repentance are always open. You can always return to Allah, ask Allah, start praying again 5 times a day on time, in the earliest time. So you can always do that. So brothers, don't be neglectful of your prayers. Allah warns you, brothers. Don't let your work distract you from your salah. You know, when I first became Muslim, I quickly figured out that the secret to Islam, the secret to living your life as a Muslim, is the salah. The secret to living your life as someone who is a worshipper of Allah, surrendering to Allah, submitting to Allah, is the salah. It's the secret. It truly is. The secret of Islam. And the secret I figured out was this, that my mentality should be that I fit my life around my prayers. My prayers, the salah, is the pillar of my life. The pillar of my day is the salah. That's the pillar of my day. The most important thing in my day are my prayers. It's not my wife, it's not my kids, it's not my job, it's not my meals. The pillar of my day is as-salah, it is the prayer. And I want to see, how can I fit my life around those pillars? It's not the other way around. It's not that everything is important and let me see, oh, I could fit my prayer in there and maybe I could do a prayer here and maybe I... That's not the way to think. You need to think the other way. You need to think of your prayers and then see how you can fit your life around your prayers. Now you may say, oh, that's not very practical and this and that. But that's how we should be thinking as Muslims. That's how we should be thinking as Muslims. That is how the life used to be in Muslim countries. When you hear the adhan, you go to the masjid, you pray. That is how the day is built. Time is built. Work is built. Everything is built around those prayer times. That is how it should be. That is what was left for us. But sadly, these pillars have begun to disintegrate in our lives. What a calamity. What a disaster. Where is Islam if we are not establishing the prayer within their times? So if a person is so busy buying and selling and doing their job, then these person and earning their livelihood, then they have ignored this warning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't let your wealth or your children. And sisters, for you, don't let your children, oh, I'm so busy feeding the baby I'm so busy taking the kids to school. I am so busy changing nappies. I'm so busy doing this and doing that. Alhamdulillah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. Brothers and sisters, if your work is halal, you're looking after the children, that's a beautiful thing, it's a great thing. But don't let those things distract you from praying in the time, preferably at the early time, which is the good time to pray. Don't let these things distract you from the remembrance of Allah. This is part of the test of life. Organize yourself, organize your life. This is what we are learning. As Muslims, we should be the most organized. We should be the most able to fit things in. Because if we had this attitude about our prayers, and we learn how to fit our life around our prayer, we would be the most organized and the best organized of the people. But we're not like that. Not anymore. We used to be, but we're not. So brothers and sisters, take these words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala seriously. Take them very, very seriously. If this is the threat, if this is the promise for those people who pray, if those people who pray, but they pray outside the time or at the end of the time, I say it again. How about the ones who don't pray at all? The first thing the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that will be judged, the first thing Allah will ask about on the Day of Judgment is as-salah. This is the first thing that Allah is going to ask about. If it is in good order, he will pass the test and prosper. If that is defective, he will fail and he will be a loser. So in another narration, this is it. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, very similar narration. The Prophet said the first thing Allah will ask about is as-salah. If the salah is good, then if you have missed some salah, then Allah will look, this is the mercy of Allah. If you have missed some, and missed, and Allah knows best, doesn't just mean you abandoned and you didn't pray at all. No, sometimes you miss a prayer because you prayed, but you didn't make wudu properly. Or maybe you didn't perform the ruku' or the sajda, or you missed some aspect of the prayer. Or when you were praying, you were not thinking about Allah a lot. You were thinking more about your business or more about this problem or this issue. And because of that, the prayer was very weak, almost really as if you didn't pray. So it may be that missing the prayer means that the shortcoming in the prayer is not that you missed the prayer, but in fact it's that there was a defect in it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy is, He will ask the angels to look at your nawafil, your sunnats, the sunnah mu'akkada, the stressed sunnah that inshallah Muslims should be careful to try and do. Or the nawafil, the extra prayers. He will see, is there extra prayers to make up for the shortcoming? This is Allah's mercy. If they are, then Allah will begin to look at the rest of your deeds. He will begin to look at your zakah. And Allah will look at the zakah in the same way. Did you pay your zakah? Maybe there was a deficiency. Then Allah will look at your extra sadaqah. Then your Ramadan. And all of the deeds in a similar manner. But if your salah is not in order, Allah will not look at the rest of your deeds. Think about that. He is not going to look at your charity. He's not going to look about how kind you were to animals. He's not going to look about how kind you were to this or that or whatever. If your salah is not in order, Allah will not look at the rest of your deeds. That is the first thing that Allah is going to look at on the Day of Judgment. And brothers and sisters, you don't know how long you've got. You don't know and I don't know and none of us know how long we are going to be here on this earth. This may be your last day. This may be the last thing you hear and the last thing you see. It is never too late to make tawbah. It is never too soon to make tawbah and to repent and to change and to start being the sort of Muslim that we are supposed to be. To worship Allah as He deserves to be worshipped. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the Quran, in Surah Al-Mudathir, He informed and He warned and He asked, He says, that the angels, they're going to ask the people in the hellfire. So these are the people going to hell. The angels will ask them, what caused you to enter the hellfire? There it is. They're on their way to hell. And the angels are going to ask, what caused you to enter hellfire? And they will say, we were not amongst those who prayed. We were not amongst those who prayed. What did cause you to enter the hellfire? We were not amongst those who prayed. nor did we feed the needy. We used to engage in useless talk. What is this useless talk? Do you know what it is? Useless talk, brothers and sisters? Music. According to many scholars, music. We were so busy listening to music, watching movies, watching sports, playing around. That's what we did. We used to engage in useless talk with the useless talkers. And we used to deny the Day of Judgment. Deny the Day of Judgment doesn't necessarily mean that they said God will not bring us to life. No, it doesn't necessarily mean that. Denying the Day of Judgment could just mean you just ignored it. You never thought about it. You never thought about death. You never thought about the day that you will die. It just went out of your head. You denied it practically. So we used to talk with the vain talkers. We denied the Day of Judgment. And then there came to that which is certain, death. The certainty is death. Everyone knows that. Everyone knows death is certain. There's so many things we don't know about in life, but one thing we know for sure is that we are going to die. And it could be any time. And then Allah said, no intercession by any intercessors will benefit them. No intercession by any intercessors will benefit them. The intercession of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam may not even benefit those people at all. If they didn't pray, and they ignored their duties to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they didn't care for the poor and the needy, subhanAllah, this is going to be the condition of those people on the Day of Judgment. Indeed, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said the covenant, the pact, the agreement, the solemn agreement between us and them is a salah. The pact is the salah. This is the agreement. If you pray your salah, if you do your prayers, you will be safe. This is the agreement. You will be safe on the Day of Judgment, inshallah, as long as you keep away from the big sin. So what if you don't pray? There is no pact. There is no agreement. There is no covenant. There is no guarantee of safety. That is the covenant between us and them. And the Prophet said, so if anyone abandons it, he has become a kafir. He's become a disbeliever. This is the basis upon which many scholars said that the person who abandons prayer has become a disbeliever. Some of them actually said, like Ahmed ibn Hanbal, that if the person abandons one salah on purpose, that person is a disbeliever until they start praying again. A murtad, an apostate, someone who has left Islam. My brothers and sisters, what a terrible calamity that is. In another narration, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever abandons the prayer, their deeds are of no good to them whatsoever. So my dear brothers and sisters, you should know that this issue of establishing a salah is so important. Do not abandon it. Establish the prayer. And we will be talking about more about this next time, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.